Hello, Eurico, and congratulations on winning the January 11 Second Club. My name is Ray Chase, and I'm going to be taking a look at your winning submission today. A little bit about me. I am currently a senior animator at id Software in Richardson, Texas. I have 20 years experience as a character animator. I had to do the math there for a second. But I've worked on a few movies, Free Birds, The Book of Life, Jimmy Neutron. I've also worked on some theme park attractions like The Simpsons Ride and the Despicable Me Minion Mayhem Ride, both at Universal Studios. I've worked at some done some TV work for the Jimmy Neutron television series, and some game work. Before I came to id, I did some work on Spyro Reignited and Borderlands 3. I've done various commercial work, as well as some direct-to-video things you might have seen, like Open Season 2, Open Season 3, things of that sort. If you'd like to know a little bit about some of the stuff that I've worked on, if you go to my website, which is www.raymation.net, on there I have links to my YouTube and my IMDb. If you want to check out a little bit more of what I've been up to the last couple of decades. So let's start by taking a look at your submission. And let's play through it right now. Cool. So this is super cool. Really like what you got going on here, how things are happening with the music, which is fun, you know, to animate to music rather than, you know, doing stuff to dialogue. So I'm going to give you just some things that I'm seeing that you might apply, maybe not so much to this piece, but maybe, you know, when you do some animation in the future, you might, you know, keep some of this in the back of your mind on the next piece that you're working on. But here at the beginning, the very first expression that the character has, it feels just a little ambiguous to me. I'm not exactly sure the emotion of the character. And as the animation goes on, you know, she's starting to kind of put her hood up and, you know, her hair and so forth. That's all feeling pretty good. Here at the beginning, though, it would be great to maybe push the expression a little bit more. She sort of feels determined, but I kind of wish it was just a little bit more obvious as to how she's feeling. So maybe you got these stylized sort of brows that you're drawing here. I'm just kind of drawing them as, you know, sort of blobs, I suppose. But if they were brought down just a little bit more, you know, you don't have to necessarily put, you know, furrow lines or anything like that in there. But if she's kind of determined, like she's kind of looking off, you know, kind of doing this kind of a face, just kind of thinking about how the eye mask is working and maybe kind of pushing that a little bit more, maybe pushing the expression in the mouth just a little bit more as well. Maybe a little bit of some corner down here might actually help, just to kind of give her a little bit. She's starting to look a little bit like the Joker, but just to kind of push the expression just a little bit more, just so that when she starts to kind of animate out of this, it'll be very clear how she's feeling at the beginning. As we go on from here, it starts feeling pretty nice. All of this is feeling really good with, you know, wrapping up the hair and doing all the very complicated sort of motions that she's got going on, which, you know, if we were doing this in CG, which I work primarily in CG, you know, we would have to have, you know, hair sims and things like that. So lucky you can just draw all that in there and very well, so it reads very, very clearly. The one thing I was going to suggest just in this area through here, again, it's an expression thing. We talk a lot, you know, just in animation about the eyes and the eyes of the character. That's where the audience is looking, and being able to push this expression as much as you can throughout your animation is going to help the audience like really connect with how the character's feeling and where they're kind of going emotionally within the shot. So very similar-ish to what I was mentioning at the beginning. Through here, you know, as she's, you know, her eyes are closing and thinking about the eye mask as a whole, right? So that if the eyes are closing or she's squinching her eyes, that the brows are going to come down. Likewise, if she's like excited or surprised or something, this is all going to sort of open up as well. So I feel like you could probably get a little bit more contrast just within what you got going on here, just if you brought these guys down a little bit more. So as her eyes are closed and she's kind of, you know, not struggling, but she's kind of doing this thing and she's kind of, you know, scrunching up her face a little bit, you pull these brows down so they're just a little bit closer to the eyes themselves, so that later on, and that would kind of stick all through here. I mean, when she starts to open them here, obviously, you know, the brows would start to come up a bit. But so what I'm getting at is by the end here, when she's kind of doing that last tuck and you pop the eyes open, this is really a nice little moment here where we get to see her eyes nice and big. And the brows, you know, are going up. This is a great expression that you have going on here. But if you had previous to this, if you had the brows down a little bit more, then that'll give you a little bit more of a contrast of a, thinking of this as more of a squash, right? Of a squash, and then she's sort of stretching, extending, you know, opening up the face when she pops the eyes open. Okay, so yeah, but everything else on this is working really nice. I mean, it's some complicated motions that she has going on there with the hands and the hair and the tucking, but I feel like it all reads really, really well. So on this shot here with the feet, I don't mind that the foot goes out of frame, that you're kind of breaking frame. The only thing is it feels a little bit like we're so close to the feet, and when the foot comes and she points with the toe here, that's kind of out of the frame, and it would be great to at least be able to see the feet, maybe pulling back the camera a little bit. Not that you can do that easily since you've drawn all this, but again, thinking, you know, maybe perhaps for next time, just for clarity's sake, being able to see the toe point and see it touch the ground, and then as it starts to go around and it's making that arc and it's doing its cool motion and the magic is starting to happen, that's fine that, you know, you're breaking frame here off to the side. It would just be great to be able to see the foot a little bit more clearly just at the beginning, so it's very obvious to the audience, to the viewer, that the character is taking a step forward, or they're pointing with their foot, pointing with their toe, and then they're going to, like, do this, you know, sort of magical arc with the foot. So this is all great, and then, you know, the effects that you have going on here is pretty cool as well. So then, you know, she starts to do the magic. She's doing the magic, and she's coming up here. So just something to try. Again, maybe not so much. You may not want to go in and work on that, you know, modify this particular piece, but maybe even for next time, or if you do want to go in, this might be kind of cool to just give it a try, because I feel like these two frames, this frame and this frame, the arm is sort of in the same position, and then you got a little bit of a stylized thing kind of going on throughout the animation, which is totally cool, and I'm totally digging it. I'm wondering that on this pose with this arm, you're breaking the wrist, and that is awesome. If this arm just got to be a little bit more straight, I know I'm drawing a little bit of a weird curve in here, but if the arm got just a little bit more straight, so you got a little bit more contrast with that previous pose, and then if you broke the wrist even more than you are, almost uncomfortably, break it uncomfortably, break it so it hurts, just for that one frame. And even here, you can maybe even try to break the wrist a little bit more here as well. Basically, what you're going to get, because she's doing this big sort of like magical thing with her hand, you're going to get this nice sort of drag that's going to happen, that I think will look really cool in motion. If you just drag that hand, just break it a little bit more, you could probably do a little bit more here. What I typically will tell my students is, you know, just take it too far, take it to the point where you look at it and go, ooh, ouch, that feels like it's too much, I've gone too far. It's always easier to kind of pull things back than sometimes to push things further. But just through this section here, just through this section of maybe three drawings, just maybe getting a little bit more of a straight on the arm so you get a little bit of contrast between the pose that came before, and then maybe a little bit more drag on the wrist as she's kind of doing the magic coming up, because this whole move is like really, really cool. And also, I almost completely forgot to like congratulate you on the camera, I'll say in air quotes, the camera work that you're doing with just moving things around. It just feels really, really nice and super cool, particularly since you are doing all this 2D. So I think here too, when the hand kind of gets done, it does its big sweeping motion, you could possibly, right before she kind of throws the magic up and it turns into the horn, like right here, you're cool on this pose with the arm. On this pose here, just as like a one frame anticipation, break the wrist back this way. So you'll get just a little bit of a pump of the wrist doing this. So the arm's kind of coming down like that, and then it does this right as it launches and goes off. I think that would be pretty cool, just visually. You could even try, depending on how that would feel to you, you might be able to do a little bit of a drag here, which might help to sort of work that arc that's going through the arm. Just a little bit more on that one drawing here. Then by this point here, you're getting this extension, you're getting this straight on the arm, and I think that's all going to feel completely cool. So the other thing I was going to mention, just in this section, and this is all really neat, this twirling that you got going on with the horn, kind of reminds me a little bit of like Thundercats or something. If you're familiar with the old Thundercats, with the beginning, with things twirling and swords and things like that. Really cool. I really dig that. But on the catch, when this is a great pose with the hand, very clear, very dynamic. It's showing the audience what's about to happen, that she's going to now catch the magic that has become the horn. On these next several frames, it would be wonderful to be able to see the fingers just a little bit. I'm going to draw them very, very poorly, but these are my terrible indications of fingers. But what I'm getting at with my caveman fingers is that if we saw the fingers just on the catch just a little bit, you could do something cool with the fingers still, maybe starting to curl in, just a little bit through here. Maybe this one's a little bit more up, and this one's a little bit more up. I don't know how many fingers a person has. I'm just going to draw three. But you'll have a little bit of a grasp going on, so that when you see the horn sort of land in the, I'm going to try to angle it. I can't actually do it right, but I'm doing it backwards. I'll do it this way, so that when the horn lands in the hand, you see the fingers, so that we'll be able to see, you have a couple drawings where you'll be able to see the fingers start to kind of do this kind of a thing, so you get some breakdowns in there, so that you'll be able to feel that grasp happen. Right now, because we can't see the fingers, when we get to this frame, it kind of feels like boop, the fingers just kind of popped into the hold. It works kind of cool, but at the same time, I feel like it might be even more impactful if you can kind of get those fingers curling around and being able to see it sort of happen. Might be kind of nice. And again, it might be something to try. It might be something to think about for the next animation that you do. Since you don't have any fingers in there currently, you could, go in, maybe try at sketching some in there, see how that feels to you. Okay, so then we get into the last bit here. And the only thing that I was going to say here, and this is a little bit of a stylistic choice, because you made the decision to kind of keep her in a held pose while she's, playing the instrument, and sort of the effects that are coming out of the instrument is kind of what's driving it, and you get some really cool secondary going on the hood and the skirt and so forth. But since in the music you hear, let's see, where are we at? You hear bum 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 bum, right? So you hear that kind of thing going on. Even if you want to keep the character in a held pose, if there was just a little bit of, as she's playing, dun, 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 bum, 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 if there was just a little bit, if it was CG, I would say TY, translate Y, in the body. If there was just a little bit of the body kind of going along with the music, you don't have to do like all kinds of crazy anticipations and, she's playing her heart out or anything like that. If there was just a little bit of something kind of to go along with the music, might be cool. Again, it's a stylistic choice. You might be like, you know what? I thought about doing that, but I decided not to. And that's fine too. It's just, it's just a suggestion, something to perhaps think about. But yeah, I mean, honestly, that's really the big stuff that I was seeing in terms of some suggestions that might help to maybe plus this one out, or some suggestions, to think about as you go into maybe doing your next animation test. Again, I think it turned out really, really cool. I'm always just very, very thrilled when I see 2D animation. There's just a quality to seeing 2D. There's just like a realness to it. You can see the craftsmanship, right? You can see the sketch lines and so forth. It's really, really nice. And congrats again on the submission and on winning. You should be very, very happy and proud with what you've done here, and yeah, and good luck to you as in all your future animation endeavors, and congrats again.